October MPC meeting was along the expected lines. Policy rate were kept unchanged and the accommodative bias was maintained. Inflation projections were revised downward, while growth projection of 9.5 was retained. That said, we believe that the MPC has laid the roadmap of normalization by taking two steps. Number one, draining ₹6 trillion worth of excess liquidity by mid-December, and two, skipping government securities acquisition program for the second half. This should raise overnight rates gradually and pave the way for reducing gap between the reverse repo rate and the repo rate in the fourth quarter. As a result, short end of the sovereign yield curve should experience mild upward pressure, while rest of the yield curve should be well behaved. India's macroeconomic landscape is a mixed bag. On the positive side, headline inflation is softening due to base effect, but core inflation is sticky and is a concern. The latest business resumption index is above its pre-pandemic levels. Service sector is now catching up fast. GST collections are strong. Financial conditions are easy. And the government's cash balances remain healthy. All these indicators bode well for strong economic growth ahead. At the same time, rising energy prices pose a challenge to policymakers. Higher crude oil prices and non-oil imports are pushing monthly trade deficits to new highs. Credit offtake remains low as corporates deleverage continuously. MSMEs are still recovering from the post-pandemic shock. In this backdrop, market participants are keenly watching the US Fed and its action. Major central banks are now eager to taper their measures as their economies are out of the wood and inflation is becoming well entrenched. But most central banks will be gradual in their policy response and give market plenty of time to adjust to new realities in our view. RBI's decision making has been pragmatic and in tune with market realities. RBI and MPC members have earned a great respect of the market with clarity in their thought process and the way they handle the pandemic and steer the financial markets during tough times. Now, as the economy normalizes, the RBI will have to gradually unwind these measures. Bond market has applauded the RBI's clear communication style and their gradual approach. This has significantly reduced market volatility and raised investor confidence. Overall, relatively stable yields in the bond market are a sign of confidence in RBI and in the MPC. Yields at the short end should experience mild upward pressure as RBI sets the ball rolling and surplus liquidity is drained. But long end should remain well behaved in our view. We remain bullish on long maturity government securities. We expect term premium to reduce going forward as stable economy will raise tax revenues and will reduce government borrowing in the medium term. Overall, a range-bound movement in yields in the medium term. We continue to favor 5 to 10 year segment of the yield curve due to its steepness. Yields are also quite attractive and rolling down the curve may provide additional boost. This area is also likely to be insulated from the upcoming normalization in our view. Investors seeking fixed income asset allocation for long term should consider bond ETF or bond index funds maturing in 5 to 10 year segment. They provide liquidity and high quality diversification at low cost and provide superior tax adjusted returns to patient investors. Thank you.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.